There's enough acronyms in the world, and I feel like about 80% of them are for eyewear prescriptions. If you're as confused as I was when I got my first pair of glasses, stay tuned, because today you're gonna learn everything there is to know about how to read and understand your prescription, plus what all those abbreviations and numbers even mean. Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. I'm Lauren, and this is the destination on YouTube for all things optical, sunglasses, and lens technology. Prescriptions are made up of so many parts that each play an important role in creating your lenses. Whether you're trying to order glasses online or just understand what the heck OD and PD mean, you'll be an RX pro by the end of this video. Let's dive right into it. First of all, the abbreviations you'll always see on a prescription sheet are OD and OS, which are Latin for Oculus Dexter and Oculus Sinister, AKA right eye and left eye respectively. Very rarely you'll see RE or LE instead, which actually makes more sense to me. I don't think a whole lot of people speak Latin these days. No shade to the Roman Empire. Sometimes the numbers in the columns next to OD are different from the ones next to OS, which just means that you have a different prescription in one eye versus the other. You might also see an OU column with the numbers next to it on your RX sheet, which stands for oculus uterki, or both eyes, and means you have the same level of prescription in each eye. All right, that's enough Latin for today. But if you've learned something new so far, give this video a like. Now, let's move on to arguably the most important part, the numbers. No matter what type of eyesight correction you have, you'll always see a positive or negative number on your prescription, which is the sphere. The sphere measures how many diopters are needed to correct your lenses, and diopters are the unit that measures the focusing power of your lens. So, a higher sphere number means you require more correction, and a lower number means less correction. A negative number means you're nearsighted, and a positive number means you're farsighted. For context, a nearsighted person sees nearby objects clearly, but far away objects appear blurry, and a farsighted person is the opposite. So let's say your RX number is -3. That means you have 3 diopters of nearsightedness. Usually a number that's +5 or larger is considered to be a high prescription, which you can learn more about in our video on how to buy high RX glasses online. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss any future videos on glasses, sunglasses, and all things lens tech. Moving on, the next column you might see is CYL, which stands for cylinder, and you'll only see it if you have something called astigmatism, which is an issue with eye curvature that makes things look distorted. If lights on the highway at night look like fireworks, you might have astigmatism. If the cylinder number is negative, that means your lenses correct nearsighted astigmatism, and they correct farsighted astigmatism if the number is positive. But if there isn't a number listed under this column at all, then you don't have astigmatism. If you do have astigmatism, then you might also see a number under the axis column. But what if you need more than one type of sight correction? That's where multifocal lenses come in, and where you'll see something called AD, AKA the AD value. Some people need vision correction for near and farsightedness in one or both eyes. That's where multifocal, bifocal, or progressive lenses come in, which are designed to improve multiple vision problems in the same pair of lenses. So this is when you'll see an AD value, which indicates the extra magnifying power in the bottom part of a progressive lens. All right, now for the final part of prescription. The prism, AKA prismatic power. This is actually the least common thing to see on an eyewear script. It's measured in diopters, which is where you'll also see a base number. These are used for people who have vision disorders that require surgery. So glasses with a prism measurement are for pre-operative eye correction. Okay, so now that you know what all the numbers and terminology mean, you might be wondering how to get affordable prescription glasses without even needing to make an appointment to see the eye doctor. Luckily, you can easily order prescription glasses online with Fuse Lenses. We make eyewear for any prescription, and any type of vision correction includes high index and high prescription glasses, which is higher than most online prescription options. If you need multifocal lenses for progressive vision, we also got you covered. You can find out more about that and the prescription capabilities we have in our video ordering high prescription glasses online. We even offer prescription sunglasses, prescription blue light lenses, and photochromic lenses that change from light to dark depending on the lighting conditions. We have a video going over our lenses and frames so that you can learn more about all our options linked below. Did I mention our prescription lenses start at just $79.99? At Fuse, we're pros at customized lens replacements, which means you can get your new prescription lenses and a pair of existing frames that you love. If you need new frames that are high quality, look and feel great, but won't break the bank, check out the frame options we offer on our website if you want a totally new pair. Don't have time to go to the eye doc? You can even renew your prescription with our $20 online prescription test. Cool, right? Check out our video on how to order RX glasses and sunglasses online for more info. And don't forget that all the videos I mentioned today are linked below. But if you're ready to get started, head to fuselenses.com/YouTube. and start customizing your prescription glasses or sunglasses today. If your script makes more sense to you now, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell for more videos on vision, sun protection, and all things sunglasses. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.